Good morning, dear students. Today we will continue our chapter participles. So in this chapter, so exercise 3, in this exercise, note each sentence and state whether it is correct or incorrect. So you have to read the sentences and state whether it is correct or incorrect. And underline the noun or pronoun to which the participle refers. So here in these sentences participles are there, and you have to underline the noun or pronoun to which each participle refers. And rewrite correctly all incorrect sentences. You have to rewrite each incorrect sentence if it is correct. So first sentence, wishing to borrow a book, he called on me yesterday. So here wishing is participle, and wishing to borrow a book, he called on me yesterday, this is the correct sentence. Second sentence, returning is participle here, returning from the theater, it began to rain. So here in the first sentence, wishing to borrow a book, he called on me yesterday, this is correct. And here this participle refers to the subject or pronoun he, so that's why it is a correct sentence. And in the second sentence, returning is here participle, and returning from the theater, it began to rain. So here no noun or pronoun to here participle refers, so that's why it is incorrect sentence. And the correct sentence will be, returning from the theater, we got caught up in the rain. So here in this sentence, we is the pronoun to which this participle refers. In the next sentence, beaten at every point, the enemy fled from the field. Here, beaten, this is the participle, beaten at the every point, the enemy. So here, this participle, past participle, refers to the noun enemy, the enemy. So that's why it is the correct sentence. In the next sentence, running across the road, the child fell. So running is here participle, and running across the road, the child. You know? So here the child is noun, and it refers to the child, the noun. Fifth sentence, while cleaning the cage, the bird escaped. So while cleaning, here cleaning is participle, and in this sentence there is no subject to which it refers, so that's why it is incorrect sentence. And the correct sentence will be, while cleaning the cage, he let the bird escape. So in this sentence, cleaning is participle, and it refers the subject, the pronoun he. Sixth sentence, walking along the street, 100 rupee note was found. So here walking is participle, and in this sentence there is no noun or pronoun to which it refers, so that's why it is incorrect sentence. And the correct sentence will be, walking along the street, he found. So here he is the subject, and it is pronoun to which this participle walking refers. So here this is the correct sentence. Here students, in this seventh sentence, in sentence number 7, surrounded by the enemy, the battle was lost. It is incorrect sentence, because here the participle is surrounded, past participle is there, and here is no subject to it, the participle refers. So that's why it is incorrect. And the correct sentence will be, surrounded by the enemy, we lost the battle. So here we is pronoun, okay, to which it refers. here participle refers. And eighth number sentence, standing on the top of the hill, the eye roams over a beautiful landscape. And in this sentence also here standing is participle, and in this sentence also there is no noun or pronoun to which it refers, and that's why it is incorrect sentence. And the correct sentence will be, standing on the top of the hill, we have our eyes roaming over a beautiful landscape. So here, standing on the top of the hill, we. So we is here pronoun to which this participle standing refers. Here students, in fourth exercise, in this exercise, underline the gerund and circle the present participle. You have to underline the gerunds and circle the present participle in the following sentences. So, here in the first sentence, I remember reading the book long ago. I told gerund is a verb, but it works, it acts as a noun. That's why, and it is added with ing. Here, I remember reading the book long ago. So here it is a gerund, and preparing the meal required only a short time. Preparing a meal, it is also a gerund. I do not like working these sums. So working is here, this is also gerund in this sentence. And I saw Mr. Patel running for a bus. It is present participle. Here running is present participle, and this is also verb, but it works as a adjective, as an adjective. I saw Mr. Patel running, and it modifies here Mr. Patel the noun. So here running, that is present participle, and present participle expresses unfinished action. So I saw Mr. Patel running. So Mr. Patel was running, that is the action, and it is unfinished action. Here next sentence, running for a bus, he slipped and fell. So in this sentence here running, this is gerund, it works as a noun. And in the next sentence, it's the boys love swimming in the sea. So here the boys love swimming, this is gerund. In the next sentence, seventh, a great wave came rolling towards the boat. So it is here, rolling is present participle. So a great wave came rolling. So it also here rolling, it also shows that the action is unfinished, and that's why it is a present participle. And next sentence, eight, we met a woman carrying a heavy load. So here we met a woman who was carrying a heavy load. So here woman carrying, so here carrying is present participle, and it also refers the action unfinished. And ninth number, feeling quite secure, the burglar slept soundly. So here feeling quite secure, the burglar, who was feeling? The burglar was feeling, that means the action is incomplete, unfinished action, and it is here feeling is present participle. Hearing the noise, he saw to the window. So here hearing the noise, hearing is present participle, and he ran to the window, means he is here, hearing refers to he, and he is hearing, that means the action is going on, it is unfinished action, and hearing is here present participle. So in this way your chapter participle is completed. Thank you, have a nice day.